Dear students, welcome to online classes. Second year Maths Day or integration course. Now integrations are two types: the indefinite integrations and definite integrations. So first of all, indefinite integration definition. Like f of x is a function, and antiderivative of function is called the indefinite integration. So if like capital f of x is on antiderivation of f of x, then capital f of x plus c is called the indefinite integration. So f of x is an antiderivation of f of x, then f of x plus c is called the antiderivation. So now integration f of x dx is equal to f of x plus c. So now c is called the constant integration. Suppose for example, integration sin x dx. So now for example, integration sin x dx is equal to minus cos x plus c. So c is the integers of constant terms of given function. So where sin x of the antiderivative of cos x. So the fundamental formulas. First of all, integration x power of n dx. So that is equal to x power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. For example, if n is a natural number set, if for example n is equal to 0, then that implies x to the power of 0 dx, so that is equal to integration 1 dx, that is equal to x plus c. Next, if n is equal to 1, then that implies x dx is equal to, so x power of 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1, so that is equal to x square by 2 plus 3. Even using the given principle, so x power of n, when n is equal to 1, then x square by 2, so on as such. Now second one, so integration of e power of x dx, so that is equal to e power of x plus c. And again third one, integration 1 by x dx is equal to log x plus c. So is 1 by x of the function of antiderivative is log x, and derivative of log x is equal to 1 by x. Now and again, so integration a power of x dx is equal to a power of x by log a, so plus c. So a power of x of the antiderivative is equal to a power of x by log a. Next, fifth one. Now integration f of x less or minus g of x whole dx. So given two functions of the sum or subtraction, then given expansion. Now integration f of x dx is plus or minus integration g of x dx. So two or more sum or subtraction, then each integration of the functions. Now and again, now integration k into f of dx, then k of integration f of x dx, where k is the constant. K is constant. So for example, k is equal to integration 2x dx, where k is equal to 2, for example, then 2 into integration x dx. Given formula, so basic formula, integration x power of n dx formula by using, so 2 into x power of 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 plus c, so that is equal to 2 into x square by 2. So now 2 to we can cancel, so x square plus c. So given fundamental formulas, some more examples. So first of all, now integration, evaluate of integration x cube minus 2x square plus 3 into dx, then find the evaluate of first formula.
Okay.
So first of all, given square root of x cube minus 2x square plus 3 of dx. Let I is equal to integration x cube dx minus 2 of x square into dx plus 3 of dx. So given 2 or 3 are functions, then each function of the integration relation. So first given principle, integration of x power of n, basical formula. So that is equal to x power of 4 by 4 minus 2 of given integration x square formula. So x power of n, then where n is equal to 2, then x cube by 3 plus 3 into 1 dx. 1 dx means x plus c. So now first one, so given total principle x power of n dx is equal to x power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 by using given principle. So now second one, let I is equal to integration 2x into root x dx. So integration 2x into root x dx, 2 is the constant of, we get common, 2 of x into root x means x power of is 1 by 2. So base is equal and power should be added. So that is equal to 2 into x power of 3 by 2 of dx. X power of n principle, where n is equal to 3 by 2. So that is plus 2 of x power of 3 by 2 plus 1 by 3 by 2 plus 1. So that is equal to 2 of x power of 5 by 2 by 5 by 2. Then that is equal to 2 into 2 by 5 is x power of 5 by 2 plus. Next, now third one. Now let I is equal to integration 3 cube root of 2x square of dx. Then root x is nothing but 1 by 2. So that implies integration 2x square is whole power of 1 by 3 of dx. So whole power of 1 by 3 is constant term and variable terms applying. So that is equal to 2 power of 1 by 3. Now integration x power of 2 by 3 into dx. That implies 2 whole power of 1 by 3. Given same useful formula. Now integration x power of n dx, where n is equal to 2 by 3. So then x power of 2 by 3 plus 1 by 2 by 3 plus 1. So that implies 2 power of 1 by 3 into x power of 2 by 3 plus 1. So 5 by 3 by 5 by 3. So that implies 2 power of 1 by 3 into 3 by 5 into x power of 5 by 3 plus. Now, fourth one, let given first of all integration let I is equal. Now, integration x square plus 3x minus 1 by dx. So, it's a numerator and denominator. It's a partial fraction. So, partial fraction means first term by denominator and second term by denominator and third term by denominator. So now integration, first of all x square by 2x, next plus x square by 2x dx plus integration 3x by 2x dx minus integration 1 by 2x dx. So now x we get cancelled and again x we get cancelled. So is a constant term become common, 1 by 2 x dx. Next, plus 3 by 2 become common, now integration 1 dx. Next, minus 1 by 2 common, integration 1 by x dx. So 1 by 2, now integration x dx. Now is the power 1, so, and applying the given principle same, x power of n dx, now x squared by 2. Plus 3 by 2, 1 dx means x, minus 1 by 2, integration 1 by x, so that is equal to log x, plus c. So therefore, x square by 4, plus 3x by 2, minus log x by 2, plus c. So, given, next, fifth one also same. Okay. Fifth one, now integration 1 plus 2 by x minus 3 by x square dx. is similar to problem, same also Hobart problem. So next, sixth one. Now solution. Now integration 1 minus root x by x dx. Now is also numerator and denominator, then partial fraction. So first of all, integration 1 by x dx minus integration root x by x dx. So integration 1 by x, so log x, so minus, so root x means x power of 1 by 2 into 1 by x is equal to x inverse into dx. So root x is x power 1 by 2, 1 by x inverse, that is equal to log x minus base is equal, so power should be adding. So now x power of 1 by 2 minus 1 into dx. So that implies log x minus integration x power of, so minus 1 by 2 of dx, that is equal to log x minus same formula by using integration x power of n dx formula, where it is equal to minus 1 by 2. So then x power of 1 by 2 by 1 by 2 plus 2, then that implies the log x minus 2 root x plus 3. So now we can complete the problem. So is 1 by 2 plus 2, so x power 1 by 2 is equal to root x.
Yes.
Okay. Now, so integration 1 minus root x by x dx, so given answer log x minus 2 root x plus 3.